My name is Ursula Schäfer-Preuß. I am German. I am since 2 years the chair of the Global Water Partnership, an intergovernmental organization residing in Stockholm. There is headquarters. The Global Water Partnership has 3,000 partners on the ground all over the world. We have 13 regional water partnerships in the various regions of this world, and about 85 local country water partnerships. That means we are a highly decentralized organization, and our mandate is to look into integrated water resource management, aiming at a water secure world. Our main focus at the moment is really promoting water management, sustainable water management in the context of sustainable development, also looking very much into governance issues. That means well-managed water activities. We are here with the UN Water Organizations as we are their partner in discussing the Sustainable Development Goals and fighting for a dedicated water goal. This has not been so in the past, while water and sanitation has been in the Millennium Development Goal Declaration, but broader issues related to water resource management, water governance, also looking into environmental problems, have not been properly reflected. Wastewater issues have not been looked into, and disaster-related issues have also not been the focus. This is all now in the context of the dedicated water goal. Let us hope that this water goal will continue to survive in the negotiations now until the end of this year or until September, when the General Assembly will approve, hopefully, the post-2015 development agenda. So let us see how this is moving. Global Water Partnership, together in particular with the related UN organizations and other partners, is very much involved. But what we also try to really accomplish is to get the local water organizations being more actively involved, men and women alike. We have approved a gender strategy. As we know, women are so important in the water sector. They do most of the work in the water sector, so they have to be better looked into and better taken care of so that they can get access to credit. This is a real problem, also access to decision making. And this is what we really want to communicate also to our local water communities, that they have to support what the women are doing, not just have them do it, but that they are there and get a proper mandate. So this is really an important issue. We also very much look into more critical challenges like river basin management, as most of the river basins are not just related to one country, like here the Ebro River, this is in Spain, but when you go to Southeast Asia, you have Thailand, Cambodia, Laos, PDR, China, all being riverainians, and they don't always get along the same lines, including Vietnam, so they have to find ways how to properly discuss water management issues and find a common language. Not so easy, but Global Water Partnership is also engaged there, trying to introduce new techniques, also helping them to negotiate. So there are many ways how to do it, that the local communities can raise their voice. That is our challenge, and we try to do more in order to come to a water secure world. We know it is difficult, but I'm an optimist. I've been in development cooperation for all my professional life, and we have always seen progress. There might be here and there problems, we all know, But at the end of the day, things are moving on. And this is what has to happen.
In America Latina.